the crossing analyses of the IT industry and international relations. Welcome to the second episode of the revamped edition of the Tech Geopolitics Unveiled. I'm Rocky Yuryankai. Today we are going to focus on the fact that Intel, a US chip company, has recently explained its latest adjustment to its foundry business model, and the question we want to consider is whether Intel's plan can enhance its own, and even the overall US chip manufacturing capabilities. First, let's take a look at these two pieces of background data to see where Intel is positioned in the foundry industry. Perhaps the audience will feel the same as I do. Let's look at the first piece. The global top 10 semiconductor companies in 2022, based on the statistic data unveiled by Zipia.com in April, ranked Intel third, TSMC first, and Samsung second. The star of our previous episode, Nvidia, which enjoyed fame in the past few years, did not perform as marvelous as we thought, ranking only eighth. What is going on? We will give our audience 1 second to look at the data and another second to think about what is going on. Yes, this ranking is based on revenues, that is, companies are ranked based on how much money they earned in the whole year last year. Intel had an excellent performance last year with an income for the whole year at $63 billion. But 2022 is already in the past, and how the future will turn out is more important. However, no one can guess the future, but if many people combine their guesses together, the result may become meaningful. The result from the combination of the guesses is what we called market value. Market value is a number that is constantly changing, a bit like voting, but not anyone who wants to vote can vote, since it requires people to bring out real money. This kind of data is quite a lot in the market. Now let's look at this data. This is an article from Yahoo Finance published in March discussing the global top 20 semiconductor companies. Intel ranked 9th and was very close to 10th. An important fact about these two rankings is that they include all sub-industries such as software design and manufacturing equipment to compare. This is like putting restaurants, kitchenware sellers, and grocery stores all together to compare. We should compare Intel with companies that fit in the same category, and the most comparable is AMD, ranked 7th, with the same vertical integrated manufacturing business model as Intel. Long-established IDM Texas Instruments, ranked 6th, is performing even stronger, showing how Intel was looked down on for its future. Intel is undoubtedly a great company, and one of its founders, Gordon Moore, published a paper in 1965 presenting his viewpoint that predicted exponential growth in semiconductor development, later known as Moore's Law. In 1971, Intel introduced the first commercial microprocessor in history, called the 4004, all of which are part of Intel's proud history. Intel is proud of its history. During the Intel Innovation Creative Forum hosted last year, not only did Intel detail its contributions to the semiconductor industry, but also invited 92-year-old Gordon Moore to live stream with current president Pat Gelsinger on stage, which we can see in this picture with those two people. So, I will repeat my statement. Intel was a great company in the past, but it is now seeing some troubles. The problems did not just occur all of a sudden, and Intel has been going downhill since before the emergence of the iPhone, strictly speaking. It all started a few years before 2008. The story is very exciting, but to put it simply, Apple originally considered using Intel's x86 CPUs for its mobile devices, but in the end, all of Apple's mobile devices, including smartphones and tablets, did not use Intel's solutions, and the CPU giant was completely left out from the profits of the mobile device market. To make things worse, at around the same time, Intel's biggest rival, AMD, which was almost driven out of the market by Intel originally, also started catching up. What did AMD do to enable it to catch up? Here I will also answer the question I brought up at the beginning of the video, since the strategy Intel has recently adopted is very similar to the bold step that AMD has taken in 2009. Please pay attention. It is just very similar, but not completely the same. AMD was also a long-established company founded in 1969. At that time, it was all the same as Intel, an IDM vertical integrated manufacturer. That is, it can design, manufacture, package, test, and do everything by itself, covering products with all types of manufacturing processes. It also works on CPUs like Intel, and also with the same x86 architecture. But AMD's market share before 2008 was very low, and its stock price also fell to the lowest at that time, only at more than $2. It was very cheap anyway. It was in a rather shaky situation. But in October 2008, AMD decided to split the company in two and thoroughly executed the decision in March 2009. The IC design continued to specialize in the design, while the IC manufacturing also focused on specialize its manufacturing, and the manufacturing part later became the familiar US's largest pure-play foundry, Global Foundries. The decision helped AMD to gradually take back the market share, with one of the key moves for the success being that it completely cut its ties with global foundries without any hesitation and turned to TSMC for foundry services. Its stock price later rose more than 30 times, showing that the company's future market value should exceed Intel. We will finish this story at some other time. So what is the key point of today's video? AMD turned from an IDM to become a fabless IC design company, throwing away the heavy burden of foundry factories and making decisions freely to give its latest design to the foundry with the best skills to form the strongest alliance, like with TSMC. With the show displayed right in front of Intel, which still insists IDM be vertically integrated manufacturing, won't the CPU giant feel anything? Please don't misunderstand me for this. I'm not saying a spin-off is the only way. Didn't we just mention US-based long-established Texas Instruments? Since its entry into the semiconductor industry in 1947, it didn't go through a spin-off like the others, and it is still operating stably, but it is partly because its products are not like those of Intel and AMD, and we can talk more about them later. The point I want to make is that Intel has insisted on vertical integration, that is, IDM's business model of vertically integrated manufacturing, but the business model appears to be less profitable year after year. Intel should have already thought of this. If AMD can do it, then we should also consider taking the road to spin off its manufacturing businesses, but it was still hesitating until the current CEO, a former Intel veteran Pat Gelsinger, returned to the company in February 2021. Not long after his return, he proposed an idea to reform Intel called the IDM 2.0, which in fact implies the intention of splitting the company, but what are its implementation steps? The way I see how the implementation goes can be put in an old Taiwanese saying, a bad show that just continues to drag on. This is because its organization did not see a precise and corresponding reform in the past 2 years. We can see the following chart that Intel released, with the chart's title being Foundry Model, while on the left side is the IDM 1.0 that had been running for decades, and the right side is the so-called IDM 2.0. Because we only have a limited time, those interested in this chart can capture the screen to make a detailed comparison, while I'm going to talk about the key points of this chart's business models. The subheading on the top shows the business direction will change from cost on the left to price on the right. What it means is that in the future, the manufacturing department's relationship with the design department will transform from a colleague to a customer, and its quotes and services will also need to compete with other foundries in the market. If the price is too high or services are not good, then the business can be terminated and orders will be withdrawn. In this chart, the IFS written on top stands for Intel Foundry Service. Please be noted that the word is now together with the whole manufacturing business, putting inside a dotted line frame, which emphasizes that Intel's manufacturing department is completely shifted to become part of Foundry Services. However, the problem now is whether Intel will be able to snatch businesses from other foundries such as TSMC with a change of its name to Service. Let's first go into a short period of promotional services before answering this question. Taiwan is a global hub for the development of the IT industry, with topics from semiconductors to electronics all attracting global attention. But how do we grasp onto the future of development trends? DIGITIMES e-learning platform is the only online training brand that focuses primarily on technology trends. Provided by DIGITIMES analyst team and industry experts, industry knowledge essential to subscribing audiences and hot topics of the 9 major IT industries can all be learned at any time and any place via over 100 online videos and advisors. Check out the description section below the video for more information on DIGITIMES e-learning platform. As I said before, the stock market is like everybody uses his/her money to vote, so let's take a look at what is the public's opinion. Feedback on Intel's proposal of IDM 2.0 was a major decline of over 6% in Intel's stock price on that day. I believe the reason is also very simple. It is because Intel proposed to split the manufacturing and design departments financially, which was shown in the chart with the term reportable P&L on the dotted line frame, which stands for profit and loss. This is like Intel has set two profit centers instead of actually splitting the company into two, like what we just mentioned about AMD's determination in 2009. Although Intel's CFO at the press conference claimed that the company can save billions, how the strategy is able to save billions was still not clarified. Let's go back to the main question for today. My answer to that is that Intel is not very willing to push to split its foundry and design businesses to enhance its manufacturing abilities. I'm not optimistic. My way of observing the overall semiconductor strength of the US from Intel's perspective may perhaps be accused by some viewers saying I am being too harsh, as Intel is only one company in the US, but such is not true, since Intel is the leader of the US's chip manufacturing industry. If it is incapable, that means the overall capability of the US chip manufacturing industry is not sufficient. If the US cannot get its hand on the latest chip technologies, what do you think it will do? most likely to seek support from outside partners, and who might that be? You all know who it is. Thank you for watching the second episode of the revamped Tech Geopolitics Unveiled. Our show is broadcasted on Tuesday bi-weekly, and we look forward to receiving constructive opinions and feedback from our watchers. If you have any topics, questions, comments, or different opinions, please feel free to leave your comments and let us know. I am Rocky. I will see you next time.